short snapshots. They're blending them all together, and it looks like it's all one continuous motion. So this guy, Ptolemy, first discovered how our eyes work, that our eyes sort of blend things together. So he's one of the important characters in this whole adventure. Folks ever heard of Thomas Edison?
Yes.
What else has he invented?
The
light bulb. Yeah, that's probably his most famous invention. Anything else?
Camera.
Yeah, type of camera. And it goes around and around and around.
A record?
Sorry?
Merry-go-round?
No.
A record.
You hear music from it.
A record.
Record player, okay? A phonograph. Well, one of the things that he invented in 1890 is what's called a kinetoscope. And inside of this machine here, you can see there's a film that goes up and down and up and down and up and down. And that's one continuous loop. And what you did was you close the door, a light bulb will come on, and you turn a crank. And as you turn the crank, the picture would appear to be moving. And that was sort of the first moving picture. Can you see a problem with that in terms of a movie theater? Only one person can watch the movie at a time. And if it goes really, really fast, or really, really slow, that's probably not a true representation of what is happening in the movie. Okay? Then people started to... Then people started to do actual moving pictures. And back in the early 1900s, this is 1902, this is one of the famous early silent pictures. The number of frames per second, that's the number of pictures that are displayed per second, was much slower than the movies we see today. Does anybody know what speed movies go today? Most movies. How many frames per second? Yeah?
I think around 30 or 60.
No, a little slower than that. 24. Okay? So 24 frames per second. This was probably filmed around 10 frames per second. And if you were to take a look at this movie, and you can get it off of Google or off of YouTube, you'll see that it's very jumpy. Okay? But one of the things that they did in this film was they had a rocket ship. It was about a rocket ship going to the moon. And some of those pieces in there were actual stop motion animation. Stop motion animation is where you take an object, take a picture, move a little bit, take another picture, move it a little bit, take another picture, and so on, okay? And that's what this is one of the first times they used that in a movie. And have you folks ever heard of the movie Hugo? Did you ever
see
it?
Yes.
Okay.
It had that.
Yeah, so this is the book that the movie is based upon. And the whole premise of the book is about this guy named George Melies, who did the movie. And this is a picture of the rocket ship hitting the face on the moon. And actually, there's a real face in there. It's only covered with like a cream pie or something. And he's blinking his eyes. It's sort of funny if you watch the movie. Okay, but this whole book was based around this fellow here and how he had built an automaton. And if you haven't read the book, it's really, really good. The first really popular animation, and remember, animation is basically drawing a picture, moving the characters a little bit, drawing another picture. This was all done by hand. Wow. Snow White and Seven Dwarfs back in 1939. And you can just imagine how much work it was to do that. That was the first really popular animated film that came out. Have you guys ever seen that one?
Yeah, that is awesome.
Yeah, you see that every time around Christmas. And this one, you could really tell it's stop motion, because they don't move very smoothly, do they? They sort of
it's kind of
like that, okay? So this one was done in 1964. Star Wars used some brand new high-tech stop motion capabilities. They used computers to move some of the objects around. Yes?
Didn't George Lucas make Star Wars?
Yes. Yeah, this is George Lucas, and they invented some brand new things for this movie. And I'm old enough that I actually remember going to see that movie for the first time and back in 1977, and I was absolutely blown away by the special effects. Now, you guys may sort of look at it nowadays and go, oh, yeah, that's so passe, so 1970s. Well, back then, this was This was brand new technology, okay?
I was the same way. Actually, I have a very similar story to you.
Yeah.
It was mind-blowing at that time.
And I remember I started work up in Ottawa in the early 80s here. And I remember when one of the other Star Wars episodes went off, I was working with computers, so we went on a scientific discovery one afternoon to see the new release of Star Wars. So.
In fact, it was kind of... It was actually really surprising to people who watched the last Star Wars.
Wallace and Gromit.
Yeah, so you guys know Wallace and Gromit.
Oh, yeah.
Wallace and Gromit is called claymation, okay? So it's basically stop motion with clay figures.
I knew it was clay.
Yeah. But these guys, they are sort of world leaders in doing this particular thing. And what I want you to do is I'm going to show you a couple of short clips from Wallace and Gromit. I'm not going to show you the wrong trousers because it goes on for too long. Because I want you guys to be able to get in here and play with the stop motion. But you can see the size of the characters there. And this fellow here, every time this guy had to move, he had to move his hand just a little bit. Because these guys are filming at 24 frames per second. Okay. Today we're going to be filming at 5 frames per second, which means that we don't need to move quite as much to get... It's going to be a little more jerky, but it will it's not nearly as much work as this one. So I'm going to show you a couple of quick clips here. The shorts. And just the menu.
Special features, there we go.
Okay, well, I'll show you this one for now. This one won an Academy Award.
Two of the most beloved animated characters of all time are coming to the big screen at last.
Oh, why'd you come in?
From the filmmakers that brought you the runaway box office hit Chicken Run.
You guys have seen Chicken Run?
Yeah.
Aardman and DreamWorks Animation are collaborating for a
so you can see how these guys are putting them together.
Starring the dynamic duo, Wallace and Gromit. Wallace and Gromit are a global...
So every time that coffee came down, they had to move it down the cup a little bit more.
...and have been translated into over 20 languages. Creator and Oscar winner Nick Park is teaming up with Steve Box to direct the wildly inventive film.
Oh, very cheeky.
Every time his mouth moves, that's it. They got to move that around, okay?
It's been one of those really long ambitions I've had for many, many years.
Right, off we go then.
Wallace is a good-natured, eccentric, cheese-loving inventor.
I'm just crackers about cheese.
Gromit, his faithful canine companion, doesn't express himself in words, but his body language speaks volumes.
There's a good dog.
Their adventure begins in a small town in England, where the townspeople are preparing for their giant vegetable competition.
It's a veritable vegetable. Paradise.
Wallace and Gromit are called into action to investigate reports of a mysterious garden-guzzling beast.
I feel we're on the cusp of a real breakthrough, lad.
The whole humor of it all is that it's all in this little cozy northern town and, with cups of tea and crackers and things. And it just grows exponentially from there and becomes a kind of a mega adventure.
Charles,
it's no small task for the creative team to bring the delightful duo to life. From sets to wardrobe to facial expressions, every detail, the unique animation style is tailored to create the fantastic world of Wallace and Gromit.
All in a night's work, Mrs. Mooch.
Alongside a host of new characters, the movie features Ray Fiennes as the pompous snob Victor Quatermain.
No nonsense with Victor Quatermain. What you see is what you get.
And Helena Bonham Carter plays Lady Tonic, an aristocrat who harbors a secret crush on Wallace.
Please, Wallace. Call me Tonic. Well, I've always been a fan of Wallace and Gromit. I mean, I've always loved them. And they've got such sweet hearts.
Oh, thanks, Chuck.
So you see all those pictures up on the wall? That's the storyboard, how they plan it all out.
...for the inventive world of Wallace and Gromit. only in theaters. October
2020.
That would be so hard for Roman. Yeah. We'll just stop this here. Okay, so we'll go back to the presentation here. Now, this particular picture is from another Wallace and Gromit movie.
A Matter of Life and Death.
A Matter of Life and Death. I don't know if you're supposed to see that one, but that's another good one. But the one called Wrong Trousers was he won an Academy Award for. It's a 20-minute movie. Another one that was a leading type of animation is Toy Story. A lot of the animations up until this time looked very flat. If you remember Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, let's go back there for a second. You don't see much depth there. Everything is all in focus, right? Stuff in the background is like, for example, if you have, in real life, if you were looking at this dwarf right here and Snow White in the back, Snow White would be just a little bit out of focus because she's further behind. Because your eyes, as you look at something, if I look at Robbie here, if I'm looking at him, Mr. Moore is out of focus. He's a little fuzzy. Now I look at Mr. Moore and look down at Robbie. Robbie's fuzzy. That's the way our eyes work. And that's how we see depth. Okay? And you can see here, this is very, very flat. Okay? Now, if you're taking pictures using real clay animation like this here, you're automatically going to get depth because the camera's going to focus on the characters, and you're going to get the light shadows, which also gives you some depth. Now, what they did was with Toy Story, that gives you a real feeling of depth because they do little tricks like putting stuff in the background a little bit out of focus. You can't really tell from this picture here. The next time you watch Toy Story, you take a look in the background, you'll see things are sort of out of focus.
It looks like animation, not stop motion.
It's not stop motion, it is a real animation.
Oh.
Okay. But animation is effectively stop motion, okay? Because that's basically what you're doing is you're taking one frame at a time.
Okay? Your animated character is motion.
Yeah. But this was a game when Toy Story came out, this was one of the first times that a animated feature really had that depth of 3D. And then the one we just saw the ad for, Curse of the Were-Rabbit in 2006, was the first animated feature. Okay? So they consider this animation, as well as things like Toy Story, or even the stuff you see on your cartoons. That's a type of animation. So what is stop motion animation? We capture picture frames and we merge them together into a movie. You make small movements of our scene between each frame. Regular movies film at 24 frames per second. If we were to do that, you'd be here for hours just making a minute, okay? For example, a 2-hour movie has 172,800 frames.
Whoa.
Okay? Can you imagine doing a 2-hour movie with Lego characters? You'd be here right through high school, okay? Now, what they do nowadays is that they sometimes use the computer to assist them with some of the movements. And sometimes they'll do a little bit of filming them like this, and then they'll do a big movement of the character, and then they'll tell the computer, fill in the frames in between, and the computer will figure it all out. Okay, so the more frames per second, FPS, the smoother the movement. So we're going to be doing 5 frames per second, so you're going to see things sort of move like this, a little bit jerky, okay? And the more frames per second, obviously, the more pictures are required. What we're going to be doing today when we do the stop motion animation is we're going to go 5 frames per second, which is a good way to start, and then once you get a little bit more comfortable with it, you can go up. I have a handout with all these slides. You're going to get a handout. So this is a good website to go to called brickfilms.com. It shows a lot of people have posted up. You also find them on YouTube as well, but folks have posted up some really cool things they've done with Lego minifigures. The software we're using today is called Stop Motion Pro. And
Action
I know,
Plus Version 8.
Sorry?
Action Plus Version 8.
Well, Stop Motion Pro is the name of the company that makes it. Action Plus Version 8, they have different versions of the software. Okay. And this is not free software, okay? But if you want to try it, you can download a demo version and try it out and see how it works. There is a free one called Monkey Jam. I've tried to use it. Sort of works. I tried it this morning. I reloaded it on Robbie's network and it came up with some error about a missing DLL or something. It's a homemade piece of software. And the camera that I picked to use today... Yeah?
At my home, what I use for my stop motions is I use a software called Windows Movie Maker.
Okay.
Windows Live Movie Maker.
So you take a bunch of pictures
then,
with that camera?
And then I take pictures with a regular camera. Mm-hmm. And then I put them all in there. Mm-hmm. I select all of them and put them into... I usually do 0.10 seconds.
Okay. So. Yeah, so there's Windows Movie Maker's free. And you can use any webcam. Now, what I like about the Action Plus is that... I'll show you how it works. It's pretty cool. You can see everything that's happening on the screen. Also, too, when you're done, you can click and say, put it up to YouTube.
Hey, Dad?
And it will automatically post the movie. Yes, Robbie?
You have those videos, right?
I have some videos, yes. Okay. Now, the other thing I wanted to put on note here, I've got a special type of webcam. Some of your netbooks and laptops come with a webcam. They're not really good for doing this type of work. You need one that's separate. And if you get a really cheap webcam, what happens is that every time you put your hand in front of the camera automatically tries to focus. You ever notice that? That if you're looking, you put your hand in front, it goes whoa, 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 finally focuses. And then the light, then you're changing the level of the light, and so the light comes out and back and forth. And so what ends up happening is it takes you five times as long to do the picture because you've got all this automatic stuff going on. So this particular camera that I'm using here, and most of the higher-end Logitech cameras, I can turn those features off, okay? And that makes making the stop motion much easier. The other thing we got here is we've got a little tripod. And the key thing with stop motion is that you don't want things moving around. Because if you accidentally knock this, then all of a sudden all your characters are out of whack and you see a big jump in your movie, okay? So what I often do with when I'm doing stop motion is I tape my my stand down so it doesn't move.
And normally your camera too.
So, yeah. So what we this is what we've got here. So we've got the camera, we've got the stop motion pro, and we have a bunch of minifigs. Now, folks who are building, have you got your minifigs put together?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to be using those in a couple of minutes. But what I want to show you before we do this is some that I've done and some that Robbie has done.
Oh, you're showing them that one, the Minecraft one, or what?
Where's the folder?
The stop motion.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That one. Over here. Oh, there we go. Okay. So I'm gonna first of all, I'm gonna show you. This is one that Robbie did. And I'm really proud of some of the stuff that he's done. This is not really complicated. Oops.
Well, it's not the one that I released to YouTube, but that one.
No, I just... Oops, I opened it twice. Hang on a second here. Sorry about that. I was too impatient. Okay. So it's a bit of a Minecraft type thing, okay? Very, very simple. And you can see that we got things taped down there. So there's that. And this one has no audio. Robbie has one up on his Google or on his YouTube that has that.
It doesn't have audio still.
Yeah, it doesn't have audio? I thought you put some on there.
Yeah, okay. I put some music on, but it doesn't have...
Here's another one. This one shows how he's actually building some Lego pieces. And building a little contraption.
This is...
How do you get pieces to float?
As you can see, there's like red tarps that are like red wires. I kind of messed up on that one, where you put those.
That's like an R2-D2.
Oh, there. So what you can see is every once in a while see a little red wire That's just a twist tie off of a, like a loaf of bread or something like that.
Sadly, I can't.
And actually, red twist ties are really cool. If you find some at home, they're great for blood. Okay, or
and
snakes or stuff
lasers.
Like, or for phasers or lasers. Okay,
phasers.
Because you can stretch them and make them fit all sorts of things. Now, what I did was that I said, okay, I've got this really cool song. I want to get my Lego characters dancing. These are the three stars of the video. Okay, I brought them along today. They said they wanted to come. And I think you guys might know this tune. What's going on there?
Now it says it's buffering. Try it again. Exit it off. Try it again.
Yeah, I'll close it out.
Oh, yeah. That happens.
Oh, it's not responding.
Just a second here.
That was actually the one that you showed was actually the third edition of some things you have to
we'll try this again. Resources on the computer, but basically they do that. They do some twisty movements and things like that.
And then, Dad, I can release it to my YouTube channel if you want.
Well.
And then they can see it for themselves.
Well, no, I can't put this up on YouTube because of copyright. Okay, so.
Oh, yeah, right.
I don't have the rights to.
Oh, there's Lego in it. That's
no.
Well, no, it's
the
music.
Song.
It's the song.
Yeah. Okay, let's close the program.
Actually, Robbie.
Okay, so what we have, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how the stop motion software works, and there's lots of things in this software, and I'm not going to cover off all of them, partly because I don't know all of them myself, and for the purposes of what we're doing right now, we're going to start simple, and then you can read the instructions if you need to. So I'm going to start the software right from the start here.
Now, if you see videos of experts reviewing this, first of all, they use some pro system that costs like $1 billion.
Well, actually, the next version up of this, Stop Motion Pro, is used by studios. Okay, so this is not fully, okay, so this is PGL1. So what you do is you want to create a new production shot, click on OK, put your name in there, okay, so that way you
can
call your production,
Robbie,
be quiet, please. Put your name in, and then you can give it shot number one. So this would be your first attempt, okay, and then second attempt. So I've already got one in here, so let's just go out and go back in. And don't worry about this message about the color scheme. That's just So I'm going to open an existing production shot. Last one. This is one that I created called VGL1. Then it's going to ask you what capture type you want. Okay? So you can use a video or a webcam. You can take pictures that you've already taken on a different camera and bring them in. And actually, you can use a Canon digital camera, and it will actually drive to a regular camera. Okay? So we're going to select video webcam. It's going to select this one here. This particular software limits you to the size. You can go 800 by 600, I think, is the maximum size. You'll see it says 30 frames per second. We're going to adjust that someplace else, okay? And then we just click on apply, and okay. So there's our little minifigs right there.
Hi, Dad.
Now what we can do is there's two ways that you can put audio in here. One way is you can load a song like I did there, and then you have to try to synchronize all your guys dancing to it. Or what you can do is that you can actually add your own track, top track. All these little webcams have microphones built into them. And so what you can do is you can click down here, and after you've built your picture, I go into record and actually record the audio, okay? Right now, it's not going to take me anywhere. Oh. And see what says play stored frames while recording and playing? You want to click that so that you can watch the movie and then you can do the voices for the characters. Okay? And you can see that it's picking up my voice here. See the little bar on the right? So that's telling me the microphone's picking me up. That's fine. Okay, so we'll close this for now. So what we're going to do is, first of all, see this little button over here? It says FPS. Mm-hmm. I'm going to click on that.
Click on the 15 left.
There we go. I'm going to change it to 5 frames per second.
Okay.
I'm going to drag this all the way over. Hello.
Hello.
Okay. We're at the start here anyways. So now we're going to go live. And I'm going to take my first picture here. And listen, you'll hear a sound. As soon as you hear the beep, that says it's captured the frame. You gotta listen for that beep. If your hand's in the picture while the beep's going on, you're gonna get a picture of your hand. Okay? Now, I'm gonna move these guys a little bit. Now, I'm gonna show you a little trick here.
Onion skin.
This is called onion skin. What onion skin does is it shows you what the previous picture looked like. Because sometimes, this happens, I do this. I move the board. Oh, darn.
Or
I knock the character over. So I do the onion skin. Oh, I got it too. Sorry, I got it on too far.
That was ion skin.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to present, pronounce. I call it.
See how it's all fuzzy?
I call it on skin.
Now everything's back aligned properly, okay? Wait, maybe, do you guys have some masking tape or something here? That we can tape this down? Well, we'll do that when we start doing the recording, okay? Just because that's one of the hardest things. So now I'm going to take my next picture. And this guy's going to lean back. Take another picture.
Whoa. Your hand looks like a ghost.
Oh, he fell over. I'll take another picture. She's going to lean back. No, she's going to fall over. Take another picture.
And the guy's just
okay, we've recorded exactly 1 second of video there.
Yeah.
Yay!
So let's play it, see what it looks like. Okay?
And then
now, you can be
over.
Much more creative than I was there. The other thing that you can do, let's say when I was doing that one where the guys were dancing back and forth, I would lift up one foot, put that foot down, lift up the other foot, put the other foot down. If I had to keep taking pictures of that, I'd be there forever. So what you can do is up on editor. Click on the editor button. And what I can do is I can select. You guys know how to select things in Windows?
Yeah.
You hold down the shift key. Okay. And then select all these frames.
Okay.
Right click, copy.
And then Control-V.
Now, then I'm going to just do paste after. So it's going to just make copies of those frames. And
so now you can play it.
This is a quick way where if you're just doing repetitive things. Okay, so now we'll close that out.
That's 30 seconds.
Oh yeah, and the webcam thing is another thing that comes along with the webcam. And
yeah.
So he won't explain
Let's
that.
Play this. Whoops. Let's go right to the screen.
Yeah, you have to click.
Go back. Play it. Okay, so there's a sound effect that you can add to the picture. So, every time they fall over.
That's hilarious. It's just like portal.
They just fall down.
Now, you'll see here. Watch what I've done here. I've got the it's in loop mode. Okay, you see this little loop here?
Oh my gosh.
So that just loops it around and around and around. Okay, and then now let's say I took a picture and I got my finger in it. I'm in the middle of my shot. I'm not going to do that right now just to show you what happens. So I make a mistake. I don't get my hand out fast enough. I go, oh, darn, my hand's in the picture. So what I do is I go into the editor. I go, I don't want this picture. I right click and I click on hide. It draws a line through it.
There's really no way to delete it.
That you can never delete a frame, but you can hide the frame. And when you make your final movie, everything's fine, okay?
That's kind of...
Yeah.
In some movies, there's like things flying. How would you be able to do this on that? On
you would do
this program?
A little.
You can. Yeah, what you end up doing is you can use like a little piece of string, or some you guys have some wire, and you just use that to show them flying. It's going to be in the picture.
Or maybe you could have it like as a stick there. And then you can click the thing twice, so, and then take it away, so it takes two pictures, and one of them might be of it like with it a little tiny bit in.
Yeah. So what you do?
And then you can just delete the one that has a little tiny bit in, so it's just it floating.
Like, can you hide the string?
It disappeared.
Yes, there is. There is a thing on here called rig removal.
And it kind of just...
But I haven't really played with a lot, but all the instructions are on here if you guys want to try to figure it out.
Also...
Okay, just a second, Robbie. Okay. And what that does is it allows you to take out the rigs, which are the wires and stuff. But it's fairly complicated. What I often do is if I want somebody flying, is I just bring him into the top of the picture like this. Maybe I put a long piece of Lego on or a pencil or something like that. Okay. And I just watch in the frame here, just make sure, well, he's a little too close. And I have him fly across the screen. Okay.
Another trick for smaller objects, which I've found, is you can literally take little tiny balls of tape, attach them to like the biggest surface area of the object, and if there's like a wall or something, you can make it look like he's throwing it, but it's really just it's tape.
Yeah, I'd be curious to see if the camera can pick up a 6 or 8 gauge translucent fishing line.
It probably wouldn't. It's not that high quality a camera. Now you'll see here that while this is running, the webcam controller software comes up here. I'm going to show you a couple little things in here. This is why I told you we use this particular type of webcam. If I go into the webcam options, and let's just a second here. I'm going to get rid of the onion skin. If I move this guy up here. Okay, he's a little bit out of focus, but if he's the guy that you want to be focused on, we need to go into the web camera and just adjust the focus.
Autofocus doesn't work that well, does it?
Well, no, remember the problem with autofocus is that the camera's trying to guess what it wants to focus on. Let's just move this out of the way so we can see.
So if the guy, it's trying to focus on a certain guy here.
There we go. Now you can see his mouth, but you can see the other guys are out of focus and everything in the back. And that gives you the sense of depth, okay? Just like a real human eye. Okay? But if I turn on autofocus, let's see what happens. It ends up...
You're lucky
he happened to focus on the right one. But...
Let's try it again.
No. Sit down, please. The other thing that you can do if I click on advanced settings here is that we can adjust the light levels. And it's too bad I couldn't have shown you the rest of that clip that I did. But at the end of the clip, all of a sudden it gets really bright. What happened was I filmed most of it in the morning, but my office faces the sun in the afternoon. And what happened was the sun came in through the window, and all of a sudden the last shot was really bright. So they have this thing called right light. It tries to sort of adjust the light levels for you. But I find that I like to play with it myself, so I get, you know, I might want this a little bit brighter. And it's not going to let me do it. Oh, it's got to turn off auto. Now I can adjust the levels. Okay?
Yay!
So there's lots of little things that you can do here. In terms, I got to click on save. Done. And then we just minimize this, because it's going to pop up every once in a while when you're trying to do things. So the other things that you have on here, you can loop through a bunch of frames if you want to see what's happening. When you play, it's playing 5 frames per second.
And also, another thing, when you save your movie, if you want to even make it smaller than 5 frames per second when you save your movie, I tend to like it at the lowest frames per second that I can. And it seems that when you save the movie, you can edit it again, just to make sure. And when you edit the frames per second there, it goes down to 4 frames per second.
Yeah. But normally I don't play with that. I just save it at the same frames per second. There's a bunch of shortcut keys here. And again, after a while you'll probably figure out what those are. I normally just click on here. So I want to go live. This is where I'm at right now. This plus or minus just allows you to zoom in on a particular section of the movie. And for audio, you've got to click in this bar down here. You see it's grayed out? As soon as I click down here, that's where the audio. So if I want to add an audio file, I click on here, and then I navigate to where the audio file is. I've put a couple of audio files on here for you guys to play with. Where's that file folder? So we got the Champions. We are the Champions. And so you guys know that one. And we've got this one. I'll just play this for you. This is from Crazy Frog. Okay, so you guys can maybe try to do some animation to that. And then I put this one on. You guys ever heard of a group called the Arrogant Worms? Okay, they got some really funny songs.
This is fun.
But this is one all about Canada.
Dirt, rocks, and trees.
And you guys, I can see you guys doing some neat animation with this as well. Let's play a little bit of this.
Bigger than most, and if that's guy post, cause I'm really proud, so I shout it loud. Though our numbers are few, we will welcome you. Although we don't have history, gold medal winning teams, heroes or prisoners, world famous volcanoes, still want to meet God's glorious. Cause we've got rocks and trees and trees and
rocks and trees,
and rocks and trees, and trees, and rocks and rocks and trees, and trees, and rocks and
water. Okay. So I can see you guys having some fun with that, okay? These are ones for you guys to play on. Okay, so I think, so what you can do is you can bring it down. You got to remember that these things are 2 or 3 minutes long. And every minute, you need to spend about an hour moving your fingers around. Think about that. So if you've got a 3-minute audio file, you're going to be spending 3 hours trying to make all your fingers move. I spent about 3 hours doing that the other video that I did there. And I've given you the audio for We Are the Champions as well. Well, we'll try one more time, but let me just see.
That's not the right one.
I'm going to use a different...
That's not the right one. That's the MP3.
No, I use Windows.
That's the MP3.
I think I like it more like...
I use Windows
Movie Maker, not live, but I just use Windows.
No, I'm gonna try the quick.
You're looking at the wrong.
Let's try Windows Media Player.
No, you're using the wrong file. That's the MP3.
Oh, sorry.
You want the Avi?
Yep, sorry.
Avi.
Oh, there you go. Third one up, play with Windows Media Player. Render open. Okay,
yeah, there
we go. Sure. Oh, I thought this is an interface we had last time, too. We'll see.
Yeah.
Let me just skip the middle. There we go. So you see I've got the twisting. So I only had them twist once, and then I cut and paste. It saved me a lot of time.
It's the same thing from the start.
Yeah.
That is how did you make them bounce on the edge?
They will tip.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Yeah, they'll still stay up. Now you watch towards the end here, you'll see how bright it gets all of a sudden. Again, I cut and pasted that from earlier, so that saved me a lot of time. It looks like you're stepping in time with the music, but in fact, it just happened to be luck. Okay. Because I'm doing one frame per step.
It's really funny because...
With this sort of disco beat, that normally works quite well.
It's really funny because it's like, hey, Bobby, what's your crazy frog CD?
Yeah, I was trying to find his crazy frog CD so I could do this.
Child.
And then they bow. See how bright it got? That's because the sun was coming in the window. Okay.